So let me set the stage for you a little bit. I was manager of the Space Shuttle Orbiter, and the engineers came to me and said, "Aaron, the waste management system on the shuttle is not working very well." Now, the waste management system, in simple terms, is the toilet. They said, "The toilet's not working very well, and we really need to go off and design a new toilet." So, you know, I thought for a moment. I said, "Well, yeah, that's probably a pretty important thing to do." So we did. Well, it turns out the original contract, and I'm quoting a little bit from memory, was about $10 million. Now, $10 million for a toilet, when you can go down to any place and get a toilet for a couple of $100s, is a pretty high number. But that wasn't the worst of it. The worst of it, about 6 months later, they came to me and said, "Aaron, guess what? It's not $10 million, it's $20 million. So Congress got wind of this. Congress got wind of this, and they wanted me to come up and testify. And you can see what kind of fun they're going to have. Waste management, you know, they're going to really have fun with this subject. And you may know some people in Congress, but the name was Mr. Sensenbrenner from Wisconsin. I remember very clearly, he's still in Congress now. He was head of the Science Committee, and that's who we had to go testify before. Well, there's a reporter for the Washington Post. Her name was Kathy Sawyer. Now, Kathy was the science reporter for the Washington Post. Very, very good. Kathy was very smart, very fair, but she really bore in on things. So Kathy got wind of this, so she wanted to publish an article on it. So she called me, and she said, "Would you please talk to me about the waste management system?" I said, "Boy, she's going to get me in trouble." So I said, "I tell you what, I've got somebody that can really tell you about the waste management system, and I'll have Henry Pohl call you." So I talked to Henry about it. Now, that's going to be Henry's introduction to this class of what he told Kathy Sawyer, because it's a classic. Henry, it's all yours.
Aaron, I almost forgot about Kathy Sawyer. But
there we go for posterity.
Okay. He's a country boy. Kathy called me up and said, "Can you explain to me how I might explain to my neighbor's 14-year-old daughter why NASA has spent $10 million building a toilet?" Pardon me. And I said, "I'll try." And I thought for a little bit, now how am I going to start out on this? I said, "You know, if you take the commode that you've got in your bathroom and you bolt it upside down in the ceiling, now try using it." I said, "That's really a little better situation than we have on the orbiter, because at least we know which way the gravity field is on that. In orbiter, you don't know. Most of the time you don't have any, but it might be to the right or left or up or down." You know, that was the only reporter that I ever talked to that put everything down verbatim of what I said, the question she asked, and what I said, and printed that article in the newspaper. But that kind of sets a stage for operating in the absence of gravity. You know, I explained to her that the space shuttle volume that the people have to live in is about the same volume as you have in a modern bathroom. You know, if you look at the bathroom with a shower and the room out just outside with a sink and everything, we have just about that same volume in the shuttle. Now, you seal that all up. You got a certain amount of air that you can use in there, and you only have the air to replace gravity. You've got to have a flow of air to direct whatever you want to direct in a certain direction. So you use that air, you run it through, you've got to deodorize it, you've got to clean it, you've got to run it back into the cabin almost instantly, otherwise you pull a vacuum in the cabin. And so whenever you start putting all of that equipment in there and all of that stuff in there on something that has never, never been done before, $10 million or $20 million is kind of cheap. When you get right down to it, you look at the number of people that'll hire for a year working on it, is cheap. But to try to get that message across is not easy.